What's up, everybody? It's Cameron Khoza. Welcome to A Day in the Life. Cameron Khoza, small forward slash shooting guard. I go to Bishop Guilfoyle Catholic High School. And as of right now, I'm undecided where I'm going to college. So, I mean, who knows? All right, so this is where the magic happens in this space. You might see it because Ethan's recording here. This is like his little setup thing. He's got the light and everything like that. And obviously you guys recognize, like, you can put the backdrop back there. Right here, this is where, you know, I chill. I got my computer down here. I'm a little bit of a computer nerd, just a little bit, but obviously, you know, gotta, you know, keep something to keep me sane. So, you know, a lot of times, you know, I'll work out throughout the day and then, you know, come home and, you know, I'll hop on the games, you know, with the boys or whatever. Yeah, you know, I got the mic here. A little bit of like professional mic. It can, you know, kind of, you know, I don't know, not many people probably just have that sitting around, but, you know, it's definitely nice to have. And everything like that. Gotta have the essentials, man. You gotta have the lotion, bro. I cannot tell you how many times I come to practice and my teammates are clowning me, bro, because my legs, it's, you know, just white, dude. You know, white people don't understand, man. Like, during the winter, like, the winter's terrible, because, you know what I'm saying, you'll go outside, you'll wear shorts, and, like, just your knees all the way down is white. So, you know, you gotta have the lotion. Honestly, those M&M's have been sitting there for, like, 2 years, so I don't really touch those. My little brother keeps coming in and, like, stealing our Starburst, so if you see, look up there, that's what Ethan hit his. So, I mean, you gotta make sure to, you know, little brother proof the whole room, so no, they don't go in. Well, that's pretty much it. You know, that's where we kind of chill at. You know, if we got friends over and everything like that, we just kind of chilling here. It's a little messy right now because, you know, my our cousin's over, so we just kind of been chilling here for the past few days. But usually it's a little cleaner, so.
I was just telling mom that
you
back from
John Hopkins. Yeah. Alright, so it's about 9 a.m. right now. I don't know if y'all can see that. But honestly, like, I get a bunch of crap because, like, my background is me. So people think I'm, like, self-conceited or something like that. But it's like, do you guys have you as your background? Is that, like, super weird? Like, I'm not, like, self-conceited. It's just a cool picture. I like it. So I have my background. But 9 a.m., got the first meal right now. I got 2 peanut butter sandwiches. Real simple. It took me literally 45 seconds to make. You know, something I usually have in the mornings, you know, when I'm about to go to the gym or something like that. Or I got practice or something. It's just a good source of protein and, you know, just helps with energy and, you know, everything like that. You know, like, I need to eat before I play basketball. Like, if I don't eat within, like, an hour before I play basketball, it's just, like, I don't know, I just have a fit on the court. Like, I just miss a bunch of shots and, like, I just feel tired and stuff like that. So, gotta make sure you eat. This is definitely not the most healthy thing ever, but it's, like, not the worst thing ever, so it's all good. It's a trap mobile. You know what I mean? Only business goes down in here. Got the movie player back here. I don't even use this. I haven't even tried it out yet, so I don't know if it works, to be honest with you. But I don't know. Maybe one day we'll try it. You gotta have the A Boogie on, man. That's, you know, he's a GOAT for me. I mean, not really, like, he's not really the GOAT, but, like, honestly, he's probably one of my favorite artists. And then, I'd probably say A Boogie 1 for me, and then Lil Baby. And then I'm gonna say, probably right now, in terms of, like, how much I'm listening to them, probably Polo. By A Boogie, Baby, Polo. And not necessarily, like, the best, but, like, that's just my list, like, who I listen to the most. Alright, so we just made the facility. This honestly has been really nice for Ethan and I, especially. You know, I feel like during the first shutdown here in Pennsylvania, during March to, like, May, pretty much, you know, this was really huge for me, just to be able to get in, you know, get work. You know, nobody really knew. It was just me in the gym by myself, just working on my own game. So I feel like I really transformed my game, you know, over the quarantine. But it's definitely been really nice to have and, you know, a really nice tool. Now, you know, some other people are using this when we walk in. It's going to be some other people. Just because, you know, everything's shut down here, so this is some space for other people. But, you know, for Ethan and I, you know, we can get in here. If we want to get in here at 3 a.m., you know, we can get in here at 3 a.m., so it's definitely nice to have. So we'll go in, you know, get some work, you know, stuff like that.
usually, you know, my cousin's clowning on me because he thinks I'm coming to the gym just kind of show up, like, oh, look how hard I work. But like, no, it's not really like that. A lot of the times I'll come in here just like earlier in the morning, you know, obviously when I'm going to school and stuff like that. And, you know, just get shots up, you know, work on my handle and stuff like that. I think it's really big for just a confidence standpoint, just for me. You know, a lot of the times, you know, I'll practice and, you know, say I have a bad practice and miss some shots, you know, my handle doesn't feel as tight. Where after practice, I'll come in here and, you know, get shots up and work on my handle and stuff like that. So honestly, it's not really a fact that, like, I really need to improve my skills, which I do, 100% I do. But it's also just, okay, let me come in the gym, let me feel the ball, let me feel, you know, let me see the ball go through the hoop a few times, you know, it just helps to build my confidence. So when I have a bad practice, I have a bad game, I come in here, I see the ball go through the hoop, I see, you know, me doing the drill where my handle feels tight, then the next day it's like, okay, I've been doing this, like I already did this drill, you know, I felt my handle tight, I felt the ball go through the hoop. So it definitely helps with confidence and everything like that. If y'all don't got one of these, you need to get one, bro. These are a must. It's like, if y'all haven't seen these, it's like a massage gun and anything like that. So you just, you know, you turn it on, you do different settings, and, you know, you just go over with your leg, everything like that. You know, for me personally, you know, being like taller, it definitely helps because, you know, being tall and skinny, you know, I grew so fast, you know, I had a lot of knee pain. So it just helps to get me stretched out, you know, before, you know, I work out. I gotta make sure to stretch. You know, if you don't stretch, then, you know, you're not helping your body at all. And, you know, it's gonna be a risk for injury. So you gotta make sure you stretch, gotta make sure, you know, you foam roll, you know, you just do whatever, just make sure your body feels right. But this is a must, so y'all gotta get this.
All right, so it's 9:45 right now. It's got stretched out and everything like that. Usually what I like to do when, like, I first get to the gym is I like to do ball handling because it's really important. You know, really helps with your confidence, you know, like I was talking about. You know, you go where you want to go, the defender can't dictate, we know where you're going. You know, if you got that tight handle, you can do that. Again, you know, I don't know what's going on in your state. You know, obviously this town's pretty crazy. But if you guys, you know, got access to a ball, you know, make sure you get in the, you know, this ball handling, because it definitely helps. You know, it doesn't matter whether you're big, you know, I'm 6'7", so, like, still, you know, even I'm doing, you know, ball handling drills, or if you're a guard, like a smaller guard, you know, do your ball handling drills and stuff like that. That's the way the game's moving. So usually I'll do ball handling drills, just kind of get warm. Then I'll usually go into finishing drills because I'm a terrible finisher. So I've really been trying to work on that. And then go into shooting drills, just kind of end it. So yeah, I'll see you guys after the workout.
It's 10:50 right now, so it's about an hour. Again, you know, I know Ethan's talked about this, like you don't need to work out for, you know, 6-7 hours a day, because I mean, how much good basketball are you really gonna be doing in those 6-7 hours? All you really need is two and a half hours, maybe, depending on the day, maybe an hour and a half even. So, you know, don't feel like you gotta exert yourself. You gotta put your body at risk, you know, working out 6-7 hours a day. You know, ridiculous. But you know, we got some shots up, we got some ball handling in, everything like that. Right now, I'm gonna go home, probably gonna stop at Dunkin' Donuts because I'm running on like 4 hours of sleep right now. So I'll get some coffee in me, and you know, we'll kind of see what the day, you know, brings us.
Strike it from the tape.
Yeah, strike it.
Shut up, coach.
I try to delete that picture. That shit makes it for anybody's photo, Daddy.
All right, so time is 2:17. We just made this protein shake for lunch. We'll get a drink before lunch. I don't know what else I'm going to have. But not going to lie to you, I kind of sometimes like forget to eat. So that's kind of why I'm built the way I am. But, you know, trying to, you know, just kind of drink calories just so we can kind of build some muscle, maybe get some fat on me, just whatever. And this looks really good. You know, give you guys a little close up. This looks really great, really tasty. It's got oatmeal, peanut butter, ice cream, chocolate chips, protein powder, honey. And usually I have spinach, but we ran out of spinach, so usually I'll have that in there. But honestly, like when I first started making it, it's the oatmeal really gets you because I hate pulp. So when I'm drinking it and I'm like feeling the pulp or feeling like the oatmeal get on my throat, I like feel like I want to throw up. But hopefully it's blended pretty well. It looks pretty well blended. So I want to taste test it for you guys on the vlog, see how it is. Dude, it's warm. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's not even like a liquid.
So, 3:40 right now. Cameron's over there sleeping on the floor. I'm not really sure what the deal is with that. So I'm about to head to the gym right now. I've got a workout at 5:30, but Cameron will be here later, about 7, and we'll get some work in at that point. So he usually likes to crash a little bit before that. Coming down off that coffee, I guess. So, but it'll be you gotta rest up. It'll be a good workout tonight.
Good morning, Cam. Good morning, Cam. Yo, Cam, dude, get up, dude, get up. It's dinner time. It's time to eat again, Cam. Come on, Cam.
Let's eat dinner. Cause it's spaghetti or. Should I say hot dogs?
Cam, what time is it right now?
It's like 5:30.
5:30?
Yeah.
Nope, 5:35.
No, Cam, dinner's upstairs. Dude, there's no... You're messing up the lighting, dude.
I'm just trying to wake up. All right, so it's about 5:42 right now. I just woke up from like my second nap. I just like took one nap and then went downstairs and took another nap. Like pizza and hot dogs and vegetables and stuff like that.
You're good.
Yeah.
You drink milk?
Of course I do. I don't appreciate the milk slander, so of course we're drinking milk over here. Alright, so 6:35 right now. We're back at the facility for our second workout of the day. We're going to Ethan and some other guys. So, you know, again, glad to be here and get this working.
time is it?
All right, so we just finished 8:44. Got to working, got a lot of shots up. Did some ball handling, finishing, stuff like that. Just trying to get better. You see, you know, Ethan's using a Theragun. So, sure. Like I said, it's valid. Yeah. You guys got to get you one. But yeah, it was good to get working. This New Year's night, so gonna go home, spend it with the family, everything like that. But you know, it was a good day. So we'll see you guys back home.
No, man, my legs are feeling nice now, though, I will say. It was good work. It was good work. And a lot of reactionary stuff, as you guys saw, where I'm giving a command, so it makes it a little bit more game-like. It's easy to go on autopilot when you're playing, just because, you know, it's like, oh, you're going through and you're doing a pull-up or you're doing a layup or whatever, and it's just like, oh, you know, there's no defense out here, so I don't have to think about it. But now when you add that reactionary element to it, where you're going left, right, or whatever the call might be, two or three, now you have to, that's another part that you have to think about. So you can't be on autopilot the whole time. So I just find that it's better. And then we got a lot of shots up at the end too. Shots that he has to hit consistently to get to where he wants to get to, because that's going to be his job. So that's stuff that we definitely have to hit as well. And all that together, it's a solid workout.
All right, so it's 11:21 right now. We got home a while ago. We just been chilling. I had Taco Bell a little bit ago, as you can see in the trash. But overall, you know, pretty good day, pretty normal day. And you know, we got a lot of things done. So, you know, I appreciate you guys, you know, checking out the video and just kind of seeing how I do things. Just make sure, you know, subscribe and keep supporting Ethan, and hopefully I'll be in some later videos. So appreciate you guys.